can you take enclomiphene and testosterone together? Well, in this video, I'm going to talk to you about why that may be the most advantageous application of optimizing testosterone, especially for men. And I'm going to share with you what happens when you take them together, what happens if you take them solely, and then by the end of the video, hopefully you'll understand exactly how and why testosterone should be taken with enclomiphene. So I'm Regan Archibald, I'm the founder of Ageless Future, and I believe that every year of your life, you can get healthier and healthier as long as you apply the right principles. I think that longevity and health is a skill set. And the reason I make these videos is because I care about your future. I want you to have a future that's full of health and vitality so that you can tackle the big problems and challenges in life that are meaningful to you in the most effective, productive way. So let's jump in. So first of all, understanding where your labs are, that's the most important thing. It's like, well, should you take testosterone and enclomiphene together? Look at where your labs are. If you are on testosterone replacement therapy right now and you haven't had your labs ran in 6 months or less, get them taken. When you look at your labs, you're going to look at several markers. First, you're going to look at testosterone, total testosterone, and free testosterone, and then percentage of free testosterone. But the free testosterone is what really gives you that nuance, that window into understanding what you have available in your body. Ideally, you want your free testosterone to be 20 to 25, so you want it to be on the higher end. Your total testosterone in men, you want that to be between 700 and about 1,000. And that's where we found that your body has the ability to protect its brain, you have better cognition, better dopamine modulation, so you make decisions faster, you feel clear. It's where your muscles, you can hold on to those, you recover from the gym, you start looking all jacked. And it's also where you have great cardiovascular fitness. You have protection of the heart from having adequate testosterone levels. It's not something to take lightly because low testosterone can lead to brain fog, fatigue, lethargy. You just don't have that same quality of life when your testosterone levels are optimized. So get your labs run. You also want to look at sex hormone binding globulin. You want to look at estradiol, progesterone, DHEA. These are really important markers when it comes to understanding if this combination of enclomiphene and testosterone is right for you. And then whenever you're using these molecules, there's peptides that you want to stack with it. Peptides for your exercise benefits, like SLOOP-332. This one does also work on the estrogen receptor line, but this is an estrogen-related line, and it's called PARP2. But what Sloop does is it's like an exercise mimetic. It helps you utilize fat as an energy source. Your endurance will soar in the mice models. After a single administration, mice could run 70% farther. Utilize that. It can help lower cholesterol. We're learning more and more about Sloop. It's a newer molecule that I'm fascinated with. You can use BPC-157, thymus and beta-4, so you recover and repair faster. You can add in like CJC-1295 to get that growth hormone pulse. Make sure you have ipamorelin with it. There's so many great ways, but it starts by working with the right team. Make sure that you are working with a medical provider who is trained in peptide therapy. They understand how lifestyle stacks with it, like nutrition and exercise protocols and sleep. And then also make sure that you're not getting peptides on the research market, because you want to use peptides from a licensed compounding pharmacy. That's the only place where we'll source those from, 503A and 503B licensed facilities. So when you're combining enclomiphene and testosterone, why would you want to do that? Well, here's why. If you're using testosterone, you want to be on as small of a dose as possible to reach optimal levels, because testosterone in and of itself, it puts a huge burden on your liver and on your gut just to break down the testosterone and get it out of your body. When you use enclomiphene, you're circumventing this process that happens with testosterone where your body stops making its own testosterone production. So with enclomiphene, you're reminding your body to keep making testosterone, because anytime you have testosterone that comes in from the outside world, your own production gets shut off, because your body's all about feedback loops. It's a systems. And so the reason why having a body operation system is really important and understanding it is because any inputs changes the output. And so with enclomiphene, you can use enclomiphene, gonadirellin, kisspectin, HGC. These all keep your body's own natural testosterone production activated. So enclomiphene stops down that shutdown. So it's kind of the best of both worlds scenario when you can combine these two. Without enclomiphene or peptides, what we've seen happen in men is they get hypogonadism, where there's testicular atrophy or shrinkage, you know, and that's one of the undesired side effects. The other danger is you can get polycythemia or the overproduction of red blood cells from testosterone, because what testosterone does is it works through the bone marrow where you get an increase of red blood cells. The real danger is higher quantity of red blood cells leads to higher levels of hematocrit. And hematocrit is, it can make your blood sticky, and it can increase your risks of having blood clots or a stroke. And so I'm always shocked at how many people come into the clinic and they're getting prescribed testosterone, but no doctors are looking at their hematocrit levels. Also look at your ferritin, your iron, because if your blood starts getting an overabundance of red blood cells, typically from a cardiovascular perspective, that's what you want because you have more oxygen utilization. But if these red blood cells get sticky and you're not getting the movement in your body, that can lead to devastating side effects. And a stroke, for those of you who don't know the side effects of it, you can have paralysis. It's not uncommon to have half your body stop working, your brain stops working, and in some cases, a stroke can kill you. So don't take this lightly. And if you are on testosterone right now, make sure that you're taking a holistic approach. You're making sure that you're getting rid of what we call the epic triggers, because stress, psychological stress, can lower testosterone production in your body. Infections, that can also put stress on your body and lower the body's ability to make testosterone. These infections include like parasites, mold exposures, chemicals. Chemicals are hormone mimickers, and this is really devastating because you can have some of the same chemicals from the foods you eat, from the clothes that we wear, the fire retardants on furniture. They're everywhere, the fragrances, and they can block the receptors for these hormones. So make sure that you're cleaning things up, and then exercise. There's no peptide, there's no hormone, no stem cell therapy that can allow you to outperform a sedentary lifestyle. So exercise is really important. Women love testosterone. We probably get more positive feedback from our women on testosterone than even our men. And I think it's such a powerful molecule. But the thing that it will do for you is it will help optimize your bone mineral density. So if you're concerned with osteopenia, one of the big risks is if our bones get fragile at the age of 65, you fall and you break your hip or the head of your femur, your all-cause mortality increases by 50% that year. So your likelihood of death is like way higher than where it needs to be. Women, when you take exogenous testosterone therapy without support, your hypothalamic, pituitary, and ovarian axis, that can start suppressing natural output. And so this is where you want to make sure you're using progesterone or progesterone precursors with it. Sometimes in some studies, like a low dose, like, you know, 6 milligrams of enclomiphene, it can preserve some of the ovarian function in women. But once again, work with your provider on this. But pairing testosterone and enclomiphene, it can be appropriate in women, but it needs to be done differently than in men. So with our male patients, a lot of times they're prescribed 12.5 milligrams every day with testosterone, or it's 25 milligrams every other day, or sometimes 25 milligrams a day with a very low dose of testosterone works really well. So here's one of the studies you can reference. This is called Enclomiphene Citrate Stimulates Serum Testosterone and Luteinizing Hormone in Men with Secondary Hypogonadism. So this is 2015, published out of the Baylor College of Medicine in Houston, Texas, 12-month clinical trial. evaluating these men and seeing enclomiphene's effectiveness in restoring testosterone levels. And the conclusion was enclomiphene significantly restored LH and FSH levels, meaning they're producing testosterone on their own. They maintained intrinsic testicular function, supported natural testosterone production, even when compared to exogenous testosterone alone. It showed that enclomiphene can be safely and effectively administered when testosterone is being used alone or externally. So you can use enclomiphene with testosterone and you actually get the best of both worlds. So hopefully that was interesting to you. And if you want to go deeper and understand what's the best time of day to take enclomiphene, well, I've provided a link to the answer to that question in the show notes below. Provide a comment. I'd love to hear how you're doing on testosterone and enclomiphene or any of the natural things that you're up to optimize your health. And I'll see you on the next video.